So this next part, I'm gonna need to do your brow, and you're gonna have to, I know you like to like look at people and right. show your beautiful, but you're gonna have to look at me.
Look at my
Kimmy. So I'm gonna try to get these brows as even as possible, okay. and I'm trying to rush because I think they're trying to tell us to hurry, so.
Okay. Well, Rome was not built in a day.
You can still,
I'll listen.
You can still answer questions.
I'm going to. Next question.
Carson, my name's Martin.
I can't see you, but.
First, I have to say it's an honor and a privilege to stand before you.
Oh my gosh, stop.
Because in 2003, when Queer Eye came out, it wasn't just a Paul Lynde or a Jim Dable of being a comedian on a game show. It was an actual television show with a cast of queer people that you led and showed the world, not just the queer community, but the straight community as well, that we weren't just comedians, we were people that had skills and could show you how to better your life and become a better person. And you did that with comedy, and you did it unapologetically, and it was fucking amazing to see you and the rest of the crew, so thank you for that. That was before RuPaul's Drag Race. This was the first show that had a queer cast, and you are amazing.
You are gonna make me cry. Thank you. I was very lucky to, I was young and I didn't really know what I was doing, and ignorance is bliss, and I just did what I did, and I think that's why the show was so successful, is that
it was amazing.
We didn't have any kind of agenda. I was just trying to get guys to stop wearing mullets and pleated caps. But it wound up being the Lord's work, like literally. And TV is a very intimate medium, and I'll tell you the story. When the show was coming out, there were some places, I think it was, and don't quote me because I might be wrong, but in Tulsa, they wouldn't air Queer Eye for the Straight Guy because it was too out there. And they were, instead, they showed old reruns of Coach. And after about 3 weeks, they're like, give us the gays. So eventually, it's a very disarming thing. We were just, like you said, trying to do good work and be ourselves and not be apologetic. And I think all of us on the cast were just joyful to have the opportunity to help people and to help the guy get the look or the job or the girl. And that show was as helpful to me as it was to all the other people, because I was a little afraid of being myself as well. You know, because when you grow up getting picked on or feeling like you don't fit in, you're kind of a little bit more shy, and it allowed me to really come out of my shell. I was nude on an episode, so I think they really, I took it and ran. And it was a blessing for me as well, so thank you.
Question, yes. Can you please tell us how you got involved with Drag Race and how you got to be a judge, like what the audition process, that whole thing?
Oh yes, I was doing a show, and this is one of my, oh, Kobe there, that's you. I pictured you looking different. I wasn't expecting the beret. This is a showbiz lesson. If anybody is in showbiz or entertainment, or really just any kind of job where you never know where opportunities will present themselves, and I've always been a person to say yes. I got a call to do a show called Skin Wars, and it was on the Game Show Network, thank you. And RuPaul was one of the hosts of it, and one of the permanent judges. And I thought I was just gonna go there for like 3 hours and like coach, you know, judge or whatever. And when I got there, they said it's like from 9 to 12, and I was like, okay, that's easy, I'll do that, I'm here in LA. And, oh, there you are. When I got to the little holding area, they had a miniature TV that had like the VCR built into it. And there was a stack of movies. And I was like, well, that's nice, but I don't think I'm gonna be here that long. And they came in and said, what would you like for lunch? And I was like, oh, I think they said I'm done at 12. I'll get something on them. I'll stop at Yoshina or whatever on the way. They're like, no, you're gonna be here till midnight. And I was like, what? But that was the day that I got to meet Ru, and we crossed paths many times, but when you're waiting for someone to be painted to look like a shelf of asparagus hands, you have some time on your hands. And we just really bonded and are just very like-minded. And he said, you know, we really need to come and be on my show. And I said, oh my God, I would love to, I've been a fan. And then and I still have the voicemail, and I didn't know if he was like legit or something. And I was like, let me give you my information. And then like a couple days later, it's on my phone. I still have it saved in my voice messages from May 14th, 2014. Mm-hmm. I would play it, but my phone has the worst speaker ever. Yeah, I still have the message of him asking to come be part of the show, and that was 7 seasons ago. And it has also been, it just came out of nowhere, and it's been such a great blessing as well. And it's just been something I've been very lucky to be a part of. Okay, so we're gonna let you ask.